Yeah, I know. That's what everyone's been doing for the past year. Every single day, there are people losing their lives to COVID-19 across the globe. Vaccination certainly provides a light of positivity in these tough times. A painful fact is that global vaccine inequality runs deep. Canada, with a population of roughly 37 million, has secured access to nearly 400 million doses of vaccines. That's more than 10 doses per person. And guess what? One of the lowest income countries got only 25 doses.
Not 25 million, not 25,000, just 25.
How to solve this problem? What is China's commitment to global vaccine cooperation? Well, with China's annual two sessions in full swing, I'm now turning to three participants at the annual parliamentary meeting, as well as three experts overseas to answer your question. And now I got a question from Egypt.
China has pledged to make the vaccine a global public good. What do you think the significance of this commitment to fighting the pandemic?
作为一个有担当的大国，我们承诺
Biliyoruz ki inaktif aşılar çok daha başarılı bu işte. Ve Çin'in buradaki tavrının çok doğru olduğunu düşünüyorum. Çünkü sadece kendinizi kurtararak dünyayı kurtaramazsınız.
They're kind of easier to distribute, easier to contain. So especially for middle and low income countries, they play a significant role, and I would expect that going forward. And I would also expect China full blown to go in as part of the COVAX deliverable and play an important role. And I think the signs we've seen so far from China with significant amount of export points in the right direction.
China walks its talk in global vaccine cooperation. The country has joined the WHO-led COVAX and decided to provide 10 million vaccine doses to meet the urgent needs of developing countries.
Why are Chinese willing to lend a helping hand to other countries?
实际在这次世界卫生组织到武汉来考察的时候，他们就留下深刻的印象。在党中央的领导之下，我们全国人民众志成城，守望相助。同时，我们自己本身也力所能及的为世界抗疫呢多做贡献。我已经做了40多场的讲座，提供了十几个药方，联系了国内一些企业捐赠药品，帮助大家一起度过这个难关。
China reacted very promptly, so we very quick got these planes carrying the medical supplies, ventilators, as you said, masks and everything, and even the Chinese experts who were very important in helping our doctors to get them know more about this disease that was unknown here. So I think that maybe this situation showed us who our real friend is.
Leave no one behind in the time of the pandemic. Build a global community of health for all is important for everyone.
只有大家都享有健康的权利，世界才是和谐安逸的。中国在构建人类卫生健康共同体上带了个好头。中国世界上是最早的遏制了新冠病毒的大规模扩散，并最早发现了疾病的传播机理。 和治疗的思路，形成了中国的方案。面对仍在肆虐的疫情，世界上已经没有任何一个国家可以置身事外。疫情没有国界，病毒也不分种族，所以世界各国解决不了问题，我们中国也难独善其身。所以，我们帮助别人也是帮我们自己。所以，我们有条件的话，尽可能的多支援世界各国。
我想这对世界各国人民是好事，让大家也看到我们中国是有担当的，是有责任感的大国。